Hello there, I'm Josh with File Heaven, and although the package today looks pretty big and you might be wondering what's inside, you probably have read the title. This is the Rossone RAD Zero headphones. So this is a pretty hefty case, actually. You need to imagine that this is actually quite large and it is also quite heavy. Basically, you can see the name of the company here. I hope I will not hit my microphone. This is a very interesting headphone. To open the case, you have to do this. I hope I'm not doing it the wrong way. Oh yeah. So, I should be pretty careful because this is a very important headphone. Very interesting one as well. Inside the case, you can find the cable. And a little bag of silica. And the headphones. This is one of those very rugged cases, like, I don't know, they are pretty rugged and pretty large. I like having headphones presented like this. So yeah, once you have opened the package, you can find the headphones, which are a true beauty if you ask me. This is the headphone, very beautiful overall design. Let me just make sure that they don't have smudges on the hinges. So this is the headphone. Pretty beautiful headphones, if I can say so myself. They have those pretty big, pretty deep and pretty thick ear pads, which are very comfortable. Basically, I should probably start by talking a bit about who those guys are, Rossone. Basically, the cable is actually pretty normal. This is a 3.5 millimeters jack, and on the other end it has two 3.5 millimeters jacks. Basically, you can use the cables from Hi-Fi Man and such. They all have this. Even the cables from Meze is the same cable, and you can use them. It is not the same cable physically. It is the same type of connector. Basically, you can interuse them. I hope I make sense. I remember that they do not have the left and the right cup noted on the headphone. You have to judge by their position and how you are going to wear them, which is the left and which is the right. I guess this is the correct position. So now that they are connected, this is how they look with the cables installed. Pretty beautiful headphones. Let me show you the fit. I hope I am going to do a good job with this. So this is pretty much how they look like when you wear them. I like having a bit of my hair in front of the headphones and some in the back. I do not like having them pull my entire hair in the back. So this is how they look while wearing them. They have a very beautiful color, very interesting design. This is the 48th, I think this is how I pronounce them. This is the 48th piece in production. So basically, they only made 40 of those so far. And I can tell you this, those guys love music. This is what this video is going to be about. This video is going to be about music, because Rossone loves music. The RAD Zero headphones are all about music. They are not all about anything else as much as they are about music. About them, I should tell you a bit about the build quality. Basically, this here is metal. This is, I don't know the word in English, but this is a very high quality material. I am not sure how you call it in English. I honestly am not. They are a special kind of thing. The word does not come to my mind. I have a lapsus, I think. Anyways, the ear pads have a very good hybrid combination of both leather here. So here is leather, and on the inside they have this very soft kind of material. They are like pillows on your head. The headband also has a very thick padding here, which is also very soft. Basically, they feel really comfortable. They are made to be comfortable. I mean, the only thing that is not very comfortable about them is the weight, because they are very heavy. They are one of the heaviest headphones I have seen. But the weight is... their weight is actually spread very well, and you do not feel them as being very heavy. I actually feel that they are lighter than most Audius headphones because the weight is, I don't know, it is spread more even around your head, so you do not feel the weight pushing like in one place. The weight is very evenly distributed. I like the comfort of them. They are open back. As you can see here, this is actually, this is not just the design, they are on open back headphone. This means that they leak and that you can hear sounds from the outside, but in my experience they provide, I don't know, about a hard to say, about 10, maybe 20 decibels of passive noise isolation. They isolate quite well from the outside noise. So if I am wearing them and talking in this video, I actually hear my voice muted a bit. 20 decibels is an exaggeration, about 10 decibels of passive noise attenuation. So you aren't going to hear like, they aren't absolutely open. The same goes for leaking. They do not leak so badly. They leak a bit, but not too badly. I think they are great if you like fashion. So if you like both music and fashion, you should probably consider them. They are both good looking. I think this is pretty cool. I mean, for a more forward person like me, for a more edgy person like me, I like the design. It has both color, personality, and I don't know how I'd call it. They have some kind of magic to them because they aren't normal. You can look at this and you instantly know that this is not a cheap headphone, and you instantly know that this is not a normal headphone. This is not another headphone. This is the headphone. So what is it the headphone for? Well, it is the headphone for music. Because I was saying, they have a very musical kind of sound. I don't know how to put this in words better, because the way they render the mid-range, the sounds flow from each other. They have that kind of very, very smooth kind of mid-range, but it is not smooth as in lacking detail. It has all of the detail, but they flow very naturally from one another. It's like, I don't know, like you probably heard of Carlos Santana. He's a very, very, very well-known guitarist. He has that very musical approach to music. Like, his guitar notes flow. They simply flow. They sound beautiful. This is how this renders all music. Like, I was listening to Thanksgiving Dance or Escape the Fate, and every single guitar sounds so lovely, so amazingly, just musical, just beautiful. This is how they render music. They are not an analytical headphone. They do not have the data level that other headphones do. I mean, they aren't concerned about rendering every single detail. They are concerned about rendering every single part that is actually music. Like, even with electronic music, you can find that they are musical, that they are beautiful, that they are enjoyable. Although, they do have a very, I don't know, I would call it an average-sized soundstage. They do not have a huge soundstage, but it is not very narrow. Rather, it is a very engaging kind of soundstage. So basically, it is averagely sized, but you are placed so much in the music that you forget to care about how large it is. You care about how much you enjoy music. And this is the beautiful part with the RE-AD Zero. You enjoy music. You learn how to care about the music and not to care about, I don't know, analyzing music. You do not analyze music with those. You enjoy music with those. You feel that passion for guitar. I have a guitar in the back. I hope you can see that. I will eventually make some songs and I will eventually put them probably on this channel. I don't know if it is already has followers and such, because I don't know, I like playing the guitar. I still need to learn a bit, but basically I am experimenting with guitar and I know how to hear when something is musical. It is like a trained thing, but even for someone who has no prior training, those will sound extremely musical. This is the word. They are musical. They aren't made to be analytical. You know that they are made for you to enjoy your music with them. You just know that. You just know that they will be enjoyable for a long time to listen music through them. To just enjoy, I don't know, even classical. It sounds beautiful, like violins. They have that dynamic that is natural, that the dynamics that you only find in natural music, in actual live concerts. If you ever been to a classical live concert, you know that you need very specific things. They also have a pretty picky, it is very natural, but it has a lot of personality. The upper mid-range, where the female voices and the violins are, it is very nice, it is enjoyable. I just enjoy them in terms of music. Don't know. Oh, I should talk about how hard to drive there. They are slightly easier to drive than Sundara, but only slightly. They are pretty hard to drive. I would use pretty beefy amplifying with them. I mean, they really appreciate if you use a stronger amplifier. I mean, yeah, they aren't extremely easy to drive. Something like Ibeiso DX2, I think I have it on my table. Yeah, I do. Let me... So it doesn't have smudges. Because I have been using this one. I told you in my video review that I love the DX220. And that was not a lie. Just look at the amount. The back is not scratched. It is just the screen protector on the back, which is plastic. Basically, I've been using this one a lot. With EMP7, because this is the EMP module I have installed on it, at maximum volume, it is able to drive the Ray AD0 extremely well. Like, extremely well. But you need to go almost to the maximum volume that the Ibeiso has in this setup. So basically, they need some power to be driven well. They sound a bit louder at the same volume settings than Sundara from Hifeman. I also have them somewhere around the room, I'm sure, because I also use Sundara quite a lot. But otherwise, they aren't especially needy in terms of amplification. They sound beautiful out of anything, including even my poor Xiaomi smartphone. This is a very poor audio source. I should remind you that my Mi Max 3, it sounds terrible. I'll be honest with you, my Mi Max 3 is like the... It is how I know if something needs amplification or not. If something sounds good out of my Mi Max 3, it will sound beautiful out of everything, because this is how poor Xiaomi Mi Max series is with its sound. It is just terrible. Anyways, those sound beautiful without very hefty amplification, but they do scale. They sound more beautiful, like the Wells Milo amplifier. They sound beautiful. It is a pairing that simply reminds you how musical things can be. I don't know what else I should be talking about them. I'm trying to remember every single aspect I should be talking. I think that you should probably enjoy the detail of them a bit more than me talking, I hope. Yeah, basically they are a beautiful headphone. They are a very interesting and unique headphone, to be honest. The company has prior experience. They have worked, the main designer of those headphones had worked with Audiese. This is why I keep comparing them with Audiese headphones. I think that they created something new and something that Audiese didn't. They created something different from what Audiese does. Audiese has a buttery kind of sound, buttery like butter, not like a battery, like the song from Metallica, but like butter. It is creamy. The Audiese sound is thickish and kind of, I don't know, it is not very smooth and it is not very fluid. And this is the thing that Ray AD0 does. Ray AD0 is much more fluid and much more flowing. It is free flowing, and this makes them sound very excellent with pretty much, I don't know, they sound excellent with any kind of music. Even black metal sounds beautiful on those. I enjoy black metal more out of them than out of more harsh headphones. I really enjoy everything with them. Everything that has a guitar for me sounds beautiful. This is how I know that I like them. Guitars are played beautiful. I like a headphone because I listen to a lot of guitars and I enjoy guitar sounds. The music like Dance Gavin Dance is absolutely outstanding. When you hear all those guitars but played in a musical way, you are amazed by how many guitars are. Or Wintersun, if you know them, a very good death metal band which has a lot of very beautifully played guitars inside. Death metal does not denote a band that is necessarily bad or too aggressive. It means a more aggressive music style. Anyways, I thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Watch my other videos. It helps if you give a like and subscribe and such. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you soon, and I hope you have a lovely weekend there. Bye-bye.